In the bullet chart, you could change the chart orientation from vertical to horizontal if you'd like to do so, and make use of the summary table option to toggle from a chart view to a table. Next, you can customize the markers from choosing different shape, size, and color. There are a number of different ways in which you can use conditional formatting. For example, you could compare with a fixed number, or you can compare with the value. For example, you want to compare actual versus forecast, or you could base it on a calculation. For example, if actual is 1.05 times greater than the forecast value, then the value is green. Now, these rules could also be enabled or disabled at runtime if you'd like to do so. In the x-axis properties, you could customize the data series display for better viewing and scroll across the remaining bars. You can also customize the width of the bars, format the axis and the labels for more visual appeal. Moving on to y-axis properties, you could use the reverse axis property to change the direction and position of the labels, especially useful for right-to-left languages like Arabic. A number of ways in which you can set up the comparison bands. You could use them as a comparative series, like to compare actual versus previous year value, or you could use it like a qualitative range, where you can have individual values for each bands. You could also customize the colors and add it to tooltips and legends. Next, under the number formatting property, you can use a semantic formatting for conditionally formatting the data labels and tooltips. Lastly, the analysis section helps you set up the reference lines and bands. For example, if you would like to display the average line on the chart. Thank you for watching.